organized. So organized, it's not just organizational complexity. We're talking about a level of complexity that's so much that it, you know, if, you know, totally in a blast our mind in terms of how much it is there. And yet, we are told by a group of people, dogmatics, atheistic community scientists, saying this all came from evolution and chance and so on and so forth, for a particular reason, because they have a particular, a doctrine behind it. Why? Because if they were to tell everyone, actually, yes, we know like this must have a designer, the universe must have a designer, the consequence is, who is this designer? Why did he divine? Why did this designer design us? They don't want you to go into this consonance. So that's the difference between a theistic perspective and an atheistic perspective. You, as a person of intelligence, you can see the universe around you. No one will say, don't use your critical thinking. Using your critical thinking, you will see that everything within this cosmos, whether it's a tree or another animal, a cat or a dog or a snail, you can see the complexity and the harmony and the precision and the laws that are bound within that system. And yet somehow someone is telling us that is a chance product. A product or a chance over maybe 13.6 million years. For me, I don't buy it. For you, it's up to you. But at the end of the day, I'm going to die and you're going to die. And we will see the reality. When we face the reality and we are then questioned about our reality, why did you not believe seeing all the signs, all the evidence all around you? And you'd say, what would you say? I know what I can say, because I know I've seen it and I've accepted it. I didn't reject the signs around me. You have to account and justify your belief. That's between you and what you see in the afterlife, if there is one. But I believe there is an afterlife, and I believe there's a heaven and a hell. Hell is for people knowing the truth, they reject it, the reality, the truth. Heaven is a place where God, our creator, has created for us, for our happiness and joy and tranquility. This is not heaven. That's why we have some suffering here and there. This is a place of our testing, whether we actually deserve to go to an eternal happiness, or we are so arrogant and stubborn, or so uncaring, unmindful, not even bothered, and then we decide against ourselves to go to a place of torture and misery and unhappiness and suffering and pain, that will be our own making. Our creator, when you compare your concept of the energy and our creator has attributes which no one gave. Just like your energy would have attributes and quality no one gave. We would say our creator is self-aware, alive, conscious, meaning someone who's aware and has a will, but also just, also kind and merciful to the creation that our creator created, and created us for a purpose. Our creator didn't create this all in vain and everything and just let it be. No, there is a reason for our creation. Every part of your body has a function, has a purpose. Your eyes, your lungs, your liver, your kidney, there is a set function and a purpose which you or your parents didn't put in place. None of us designed, or you know what, the purpose of the inner cells, the cochlea in our ears, is to make us hear and have a fine balance as I'm standing. We didn't design it. The whole body, we are told we have no purpose. Our purpose is to be happy and to make money and to have man or a woman in our life, and that's it, and live and die like that. No, we have a purpose in our life, because all part of our body, your shoes have a purpose. And yet, we don't have a purpose. Our purpose is to recognize our creator and be grateful to our creator. If someone gave you, you know, a kidney or a lung or a heart transplant when he needed it, you would be grateful and thankful to that person, because that person gave you out of their own kindness and generosity, perhaps. And being grateful and being thankful, showing that gratitude, is your natural response. When you have a heart transplant from someone, or a kidney from some donor, you would be thankful to them, say thank you. Our creator given us all of it, two kidneys, lungs and a heart and a digestive system and so on. Our natural response, we say, should be one of gratitude. Thank you. And that is what we say is the purpose of our life is, to be grateful to our creator and to live our life according to what our creator wants us to live. so that this is linked with the hereafter.
So yeah? That's, you're talking now about religion.
Yes.
I don't want to talk.
That's fine, because you had to go. I just want to summarize this before you go.
Yes, I don't want to talk about religion.
No problem.
I think I don't have enough facts. So you can believe in the creator if you want to. I don't want to disturb you. But I want to be like, I'm still living with facts. Thank you.
That's fine. It's a matter of nothing. It's people's own choice. So let them choose what they have to choose.